Dear students, today we will be discussing super heterodyne receiver. So in the last class we had discussed different modulation techniques. So you must be remembering that in modulation technique we have an modulating signal or the message signal which is being modulated onto the carrier signal and is being transmitted. So this particular modulated signal has to be received at the receiver, and the original message signal has to be retrieved back. So this super heterodyne receiver works at the receiving station where you will be extracting the message signal out of the carrier signal. Now heterodyning is a process of mixing two signals with different frequencies to produce a new signal. So it is very similar to amplitude modulation where you are mixing the message signal and the carrier signal. So here the new signal that is being produced is known as the intermediate frequency signal, and the term super heterodyne refers to creating this intermediate frequency signal. Now at the receiver, now you must be thinking at the receiver you have only one signal, that is a carrier signal being received. So where is the second signal available at the receiving station? Okay, so you have the carrier signal which is carrier, which is having the information signal embedded into it and being transmitted from the transmitter and reaching the receiving station, and you have one internal signal being generated, and you are comparing the signals, or you are mixing the two signals, these two signals together to get the information out of it. So you will be selectively removing some unwanted signals under unwanted frequencies, and you will be receiving only the frequencies that are exactly required for extracting the message signal out of it. Now amplitude modulation is one of the examples for this particular heterodyning, and in and we'll look at the block diagram. So we can divide this particular super heterodyne receiver into three stages. First is the receiving stage, where you have radio frequency stage, where you have radio frequency signal, filter, amplifier, then you have mixer with a local oscillator. Then you have a second stage which is known as the intermediate frequency amplifier stage, where your frequency of the signal is in the intermediate frequency range, and ultimately you have the audio amplifier where your output is being received and it is sent to speaker to reproduce the audio signal that is being sent. So you can see that here you have an antenna. So this antenna will be receiving the carrier signal. So once a carrier signal is received, what happens? The antenna will be generating some voltage signals corresponding to the signal that is received. So that particular voltage signal will be received or sent to the RF stage, where you have some tuning and amplification happening. So what do you mean by tuning? In communication, tuning basically means to selectively remove some frequencies and choose some other frequencies. So if you are able to choose some frequencies and remove some frequencies, that process is known as tuning. So here in RF stage, what happens is that it will be selecting some signals, some required signals, and removing others. We'll see with an example how this is done, and we'll be providing some amplification also. As you know, the carrier signal that is being transmitted from the transmitter is traveling through the channel, some medium, and it will be received here. So in this process there will be some reduction in the power levels which needs to be amplified. So some amplification is being done. Also some noise may be entering this particular signal while it is being transmitted at the channel section. So that is also has to be removed. So it will be selectively removing some frequencies, and it will be choosing some frequencies. It also amplifies the signal level to account for the noise that might be introduced at later stages. So such things are being done in the RF tuning and amplification section, where still your frequency is at the frequency is at carrier frequency, and you will be removing some frequency components out of it. Now you have mixer and oscillator. This is the most important section of this super heterodyne receiver, and this particular receiver receives its this name due to the process that is happening in this mixer and oscillator. So first of all, what is this local oscillator? Local oscillator is a device which is used to produce some signal of a particular frequency. So you must be remembering that in a heterodyning you will be mixing two signals together. So you have carrier being received at this carrier frequency, and you have local oscillator which is at another frequency. So you will be mixing these together in the mixer, and it will be producing intermediate frequency signal, okay, some signals, and that will be in the intermediate frequency range. So we'll take an example. The input signal, which is a carrier, is at 1 megahertz. So you have a local oscillator which is generating another signal which is at 0.75 megahertz. So once you mix them together, when you sum them together and get or take the difference and sum, you will be getting two set of signals. That is, you have 0.75 megahertz here, you have the signal, original signal here at 1 megahertz, you have the different signal f1 minus f2 point at 2.25 megahertz, and f1 plus f2 at 1.75 megahertz. So you take a sum, you take a difference, you will be getting two signals. So these signals are being removed, this is not available now. You have two signals available, f1 minus f2 and f1 plus f2. Now what happens is that now you will be moving to the next stage, which is the intermediate frequency stage. So this intermediate frequency stage will be selecting the difference component. It will be omitting the higher frequency component, and it will be selecting only the difference component. So it will be, say, it's a bandpass filter. That is, it will be allowing certain range of frequencies to pass through. So it will be only, it will be this particular filter will be tuned in accordance with the local oscillator values. Suppose now you can see that your resultant difference signal is at 0.25 megahertz. Suppose I change my local oscillator value to 0.5 megahertz. Instead of 0.75, I am having 0.5 megahertz. Now what will be the resultant signal? F1 minus F2 will be 0.5 megahertz. So instead of 0.25 megahertz. Similarly, if I have local oscillator signal at 0.9 megahertz, I will be getting the resultant signal at 0.1 megahertz. Okay, so by changing the frequency of this local oscillator, you are basically selecting or choosing the frequency of the resultant signal. So this process is known as tuning. So you are basically changing the some components in this local oscillator, variable components in the local oscillator, in order to change the frequency that is being generated here, and in turn resulting signal frequency is being varied. So this filter will be tuned in order to select that particular frequency only, so that you will be getting the output which is required for us. Now at intermediate frequency stage, it will be selecting the difference component, and rest of the components will be removed, and this particular signal also will be amplified. It will be amplified and it will be sent to the demodulator. Demodulator is a stage where your information signal is recovered. So you still have information signal being embedded into this intermediate frequency signal, so you have to extract the information out of it. So that particular modulating signal or the message signal is just received at which is at the output of the demodulator will be amplified and will be applied to the loudspeaker. Now we'll see how the entire process is done. So you can see that S1 is the signal that is required, or the signal that is being coming received at the antenna, and this is the local oscillator frequency. So your x-axis is frequency, y-axis is amplitude. So your S1 amplitude is small, but your local oscillator amplitude is high, but it is at a lower frequency. Now you can see that here you have an image signal. S2 is considered as the image signal, and this particular figure, this figure 1 is at the radio frequency stage. This signal will be sent to radio frequency stage, and this S2 will be removed at RF stage. So what is the importance of S2 or the image signal of S1? So this image signal will be in comparison with the local oscillator signal. So you'll have a local oscillator signal. In comparison to local oscillator signal, this S2 will be positioned. So what is importance of S2? concept of image signal. Suppose S1 is 110 MHz, which is a modulating signal. Local oscillator frequency is 100 MHz. So intermediate frequency signal will be the difference of these two, 110 minus 100, which will be giving you 10 MHz signal. Okay, you'll be getting a different signal as 10 MHz. Suppose you have the same local oscillator signal at 100 MHz, but you have an S2, which is an image of S1, which is differing by 10 MHz at 90 MHz. So what will be IF, intermediate frequency output obtained? It will be 10 MHz. So, but your message or the information is embedded only onto 110 MHz signal. This 90 MHz signal doesn't have any information in it. It is just a signal only. So we don't require this S2. So at this RF frequency stage, S2 will be removed. Okay, S2 will be removed, and if some other components are there, noise components, such components also will be removed. So to the mixer, we will be providing this signal. You have the local oscillator signal, you have the radio frequency signal. So these are at higher frequencies. We have seen the example, these are at higher frequencies. So as the output, at the output of the mixer, what happens? You will be getting an intermediate frequency. Okay, so here you can see that this is the message signal S1. And what about the other signals that are available here? Here you have a larger signal, here you have a smaller signal, here also you have a smaller signal. These are all associated signals which does not carry any information. It can be due to noise, can be due to some other factors. These frequencies do not carry any information, only S1 carries the information. So, but at the mixer input, all these components are compared with local oscillator. Say 1, 2, 3, 4. We require only 2. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the 4 components are, frequency components are compared with local oscillator. So 4 frequencies are generated. So here your frequency is higher. So once you take the difference, you'll have a lower frequency. So that's why your axis is shifting towards the left side. So you have a lower frequency here. So you have 4 components. LO minus 1, LO minus 2, LO minus 3, LO minus 4. You have all the 4 components available here. So these 4 components doesn't carry the information. Only this particular signal carries information. So at the IF filter, only this signal will be passed. That's why it's called a band pass. So you'll have a range of frequency, a band of frequency which will pass through. It will neglect all other, remove all other frequencies. So only this range of frequency is passed, and rest of the frequencies 1, 3 and 4 are removed. So at the IF filter output, you will only have S1, which was originally here. Okay, but at a lower frequency. So the message, the information in the signal is not removed, only the frequency is being reduced. The carrier, which is at a higher frequency, so you are reducing the frequency levels to a lower value so that you are able to work upon this lower frequency component at the demodulator. Okay, so the importance of or the advantage of this super heterodyne receiver is that from very high frequency signal levels, you are reducing the frequency levels. Okay, so you are reducing the frequency levels, so which so that you can easily design the modulator which can be optimized and which can be used in a better manner or more efficiently, as well as cheaply it can be produced. So remember, super heterodyning is a process of mixing the carrier signal along with the local oscillator signal in order to selectively remove some signals and take only the image signal information signal that is available in the carrier signal. All other frequencies will be removed, and you at the demodulator you can extract the information out of that particular signal, carrier signal which is being reduced, which is at a reduced frequency level. So thank you.